Hello, YouTubians, and welcome back. Let's play Shining Force 3 with me, Blue Ankylo. Last episode, we spent some time exploring the town of some name we'll never ever hear again. And now we're going to rush off to possibly save Symbios. Again, we sort of helped him once already.
There's the Republic Army!
Well, that's the one of the many, many traitorous Republic Armies.
Another beast! Swarm it!
Wow, they're really weak. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10... It took like 10 attacks to kill one vampire bat. Wow.
The beasts have turned vicious! They attack in broad daylight! What has possessed them?
Maybe my imagination, but I think they've gotten stronger too. We should be safe after crossing the bridge.
Not if you're playing Dragon Quest. Enemies get stronger when you cross bridges. The rule. That's what Medion's explaining.
Beasts attacking in broad daylight? It's unusual for beasts to be so brazen.
I think it's safe to assume something strange is happening.
We've been fighting beasts for days! How many monsters have been in the Imperial Army? Come on!
What could be
causing this?
I can't be certain just yet. However, this puzzle is coming together, one piece at a time.
You guys are all crazy.
I have a feeling we'll find some answers soon. We shouldn't dally. Let's cross the bridge and follow their tracks.
I mean, seriously, we find monsters all over the place, all the time. It's the way of the JRPG, but most RPG. Alright, so we got some Skaven. Got some worms again. We've got, you know, maybe some ruins. More goblins. Well, goblins and Skaven. So the goblins use the axe-type weapon. Skavens use the swords. Another one of these vampire bats. They must have done, like, one damage to it per hit. Those soldiers were terrible. It doesn't look that dangerous, right? This will be a fairly easy fight. Let's just start rushing up. We've got our bird soldier. Got our ninja. I'm looking forward to Azuki, honestly. I'm really hyped to see how well she turns out. Oh, I forgot. I should maybe do this between battles. That protect milk that we've been saving and I store in the storage. Pretty sure I have one of those somewhere, right? I saved one of those? Pretty sure. I probably want to give it to Hazuki. Because she's got such long movement, she's got a great movement range and a pretty reasonable ranged attack to go with her melee attack. She's very versatile. So giving her a bit of defense, because she's a little bit low on that, I think will be a good idea. Basically, I figured she'll get the most use out of it, other than maybe the bird soldier. Zero, I don't know. At least he can use the wing type weapons, which give him a little bit of a boost. Can't quite get close enough there for a good spell. So yeah, like, this is kind of proving my point. Just how far she can zip up like this. She's not doing tons of damage yet. I might give her a power wine as well. A boost to her strength and defense would be really valuable. Skaven seem very weak. One damage to the bird is, like, I don't know, kind of silly. I thought Hazuki had less defense than them, actually, but what do I know? Alright, well, we want Campbell to get the kill here. Put him, like, over on the front so he's... No! I forgot to re-equip the weapon. I thought he had his spear equipped. That was my bad. Got lazy. Badoop. I got an email. Pretty important. Right, you're still working on your knife. Well, who's level 6 still? We've got Campbell, I think Hazuki could use a kill. Or level up. Use the level up. We use our map on this battle. Rock could get a level up. He's still salty about being tossed in the river. There we go. No strength, sadly, but... alright. Yeah, I guess the bird took a little bit of damage, so... now, I'll talk about it more later, but there is actually some logic to promoting Eruto at level 10, rather than waiting till 17 like we did in Scenario 1 for everyone. I'll talk about it when we get there, but it has to do with what spells he can learn. And learning the right spells earlier, because they're so valuable. I have to look up the exact numbers, but... I guess we should deal with the ruins first. Sort of leave that tile open. We'll see how Zero's wing attack works. It should be, well, essentially the same as Eldar. And once he gets that to level 2, he'll be doing pretty good damage, I think. You know, if Zero's got those kind of stats right now already, he's definitely off to a much stronger start than Eldar was. Like, she turned out pretty amazing, but early on, you know, I had my doubts. I'm gonna switch back to the Epee so he can get his turn quicker for Midian. Probably gonna only send, like, Campbell and Hazuki into the ruins. Maybe a couple other people, but mostly the high movement. That's all you really need. Pretty sure this is one of the easier maps in the game. Like, the ruins aren't very difficult, and the enemies on the overworld here are pretty weak. I don't really want Zero soloing everything. I sent him into the ruins too, to be honest. Yeah, we'll just let someone else get the kill and then be fine. Yeah, like Hazuki. Well, hopefully. I don't know if she can do enough damage, to be honest. Nah. Lame. Well, that's what I get. Changed my mind again. See, I was hoping Midian with the Epee equipped, I was hoping that he might go first, and then he could unlock the ruins, but he definitely does not go first. Okay, remember, Blue, switch over to the spear if you want to use the spear. Right, so his Iron Lance is doing a lot of damage now, because we just upgraded it. So that is good to know. He's got one of the much stronger, short-range weapons. Wow. Definitely one of the worst level-ups for Campbell I've seen yet. Who else needs the levels now? Waltz and Hazuki. Alright, well, we'll try to let one of them get the kill. I don't think Waltz is going to have the movement range to attack this one, though. That's good. One of the friendships I was looking to set up there. There's lots of enemies on the map. So... yeah, it's not even close. Waltz does have a difficult time keeping up with the team. As we've discussed. Alright, so... I'm actually gonna save the kill for Waltz. I'm gonna send Hazuki and everyone else into the ruins right now to save some time.
Lie, no lie! I'm taking the treasure in these ruins, and nothing can stop me!
Those bandits intend to steal the treasure from those ruins! Prince Medion, if we have the troops to spare, we should stop them!
Alright, Zero, you're going in. Flyers are good. Long movers are good. Or high movers. I don't know. Whatever you want to call them. That'll be enough. Alright, so we're going to use Waltz to get the kill. Medion kind of helped defend the back row here. You're going to go heal up. Synthesis. But yeah, I guess with Ryudo, I forget the details, but I think he learns Aura at like level 1 or, well, maybe not 1, but like level 2 or 3 promoted. But even if you took him to level 20 unpromoted, he does not learn it, I believe. Which is why you might want to promote him early to get Aura. I think. I'll have to look it up. I'll talk about that more once I've looked it up. But it works like that for some characters. Sometimes you'll learn... no attack, that's too bad. Sometimes you can learn spells kind of earlier by non-promoting, and I think that's a better way to balance it. But sometimes promoting to the advanced class unlocks different spells quicker, you know. I think Shining Force 2, it was very balanced. So, like, the promotion level was 20 in that one. You would either learn a spell at level 25 or promoted level 5. So it was pretty fair. Like, you know, you didn't really get an early spell that way. Shining Force 3 isn't quite like that. I might want to try to block up that bridge, to be honest. Well, the goblins are pretty weak. They'll go down... I maybe should have put Bernard by Medion for the extra damage, but... looks like we'll be okay. I think it's likely they'll cross the bridge and attack Medion, as long as he's open for attack. He threw that knife really hard. I don't know what you consider critical when you're throwing a knife. I guess he hit a weak spot. He hit him right in the eye or something, right? How's Uryudo's level doing anyway? He's got a ways to go. He does have quite a lot of MP these days, so I don't mind spamming a few more heals than... well, I've been doing it since the beginning of the game, but I feel like, you really should spend all of your healers MP every battle. There's not much excuse for finishing the battle with, you know, 15 MP that you could have turned into, 50 experience? That's not bad. Oh, sure. For whatever reasons, the Skaven and the Goblins just seem really weak compared to roster of the appropriate leveled characters on your side. Just seems that way. Okay, so we finally get to look at the ruins. I will want that. Interestingly, that wasn't even a locked chest. I think that's the first time I've seen the thieves grab a non-locked chest. So we really need to rush here. I think one thief will exit this door and one will exit that door. One of them will probably require getting hit twice. The other one we probably only need to hit once. Just gonna put Zero over here because he can fly up, whereas the rest of the team has to kind of take the stairs. Maybe I'll send Campbell this way. And maybe I'll have Rock drop down in front of him or something. I don't know which... Probably the thief that goes the longer route, that's further away from us, will require... He'll probably have the two chests that we need to hit twice. Whereas the one that comes the closer route probably just takes one hit, I would guess. There you go, synthesis. Awesome, everyone come at me. Unfortunately, we're getting all these kills here, and Hazuki? I believe that was her name. She's still level 6. She needs the kills. I think the thieves give more experience though, so if I can get her a kill of them, they'll probably give her like 40 or something. That's fine. Sure, friends with synthesis. That's level 2 on the friendship meter, I believe, and that means a bigger boost to magic and attack. I'm really liking the damage we can do. Like, the balance seems a little bit easy, but it's nice to smack these enemies around a bit. I do know we're getting pretty close to the end of chapter 2, though, so it won't take too long before we get some more difficult fights. Alright, well, I'm gonna guess maybe that the one with the two chests is the one that's gonna go this way. Sort of block this route up, although that won't really help much. What we need is people that are very quick to hit the guy that takes the longer route, because he's difficult to catch. And I'm pretty sure the lock chest will be the more rare drop that we really want. The mithril's nice, but, you know, we could miss out on it. It wouldn't kill us. I'm going to put Rock down here just to sort of help. I mean, yeah, it should be fine. Alright. Synthesis. I'm pretty sure she's going to get a spell as soon as she gets a level up. So I'm looking forward to that. She's got lots of friends, I like that too. Who needs the kill? Nobody specifically. Anyone like close to a level up? Not really. Don't have any real big preference. She might have done enough damage with her rod to kill it, but I don't know. Because your wizards and clerics get so little strength growth, most of their damage relies on getting new weapons, and we haven't gotten any in a while. So I think we're going to send the little group the long way around here, so we can start trying to lure out some of those enemies, and then maybe the ruins group will deal with the bats. Well, the ruins group can deal with the worm bats, and then this group can deal with the goblins and the bats. Really, I'm just trying to clear this map quickly, because it's not that difficult. build up some friendships and some weapon skills. Otherwise, not much to worry about. Alright. Protect ring. Yeah, I'd like that. Okay. Oh, he actually attacked! They generally don't do that unless you've completely blocked the route to the exit. That's interesting. Okay, so we can get... Let's see. I think Rock, maybe, and Zero can deal with this guy, and then the other two can deal with that guy. One hit will drop the Protect Ring, and then the second one will hit the Mithril. This guy only really needs to get hit once, and it's not as big of a deal. Actually gonna have Zero attack this guy. Because it's more important that we get the two drops here. I don't want him to, like, miss or something ridiculous. And maybe Hazuki can get the kill anyway. 20 damage. Eh, maybe. Nice! Lots of room. Good. So that gets us all the treasure. She actually did not get very much experience, but, okay. Now we'll lock this guy up so he can't escape or anything weird. And we'll just kill him. Not that a healing drop is terribly valuable, but... well, it's better than a medical herb. I think a normal axe will kill 8 damage. Cool. Well, that was a pretty easy ruins. Not a lot of experience, but just the two thieves. Got all the treasure. Good, good. Yeah, we escaped alright. Another cultural monument destroyed. Right, well, you're going this way. Can just get across the bridge. One of them. Bernard! Not great defense. Marianne will be fine though. He didn't attack! Cowards. Alright, we're gonna start flying the other team. We'll call these guys Squad B. Okay. I don't think I want to attack right now, to be honest. Maybe wait one more round, just so everyone's ready to go. If I have to attack that line... Let's make sure most of the crew can actually get in there. Or, you know, they provide the perfect choke point. Of course, good for them. Oh. Don't crash on me, game. Come on. Hold it together for blue. I don't know what's going on again. Every now and then. He crashed? Again, I don't know if you guys just had a big, huge lag spike or what exactly happened there at the moment. Definitely had some sort of emulator problem every now and then. I haven't figured out what the source of that is yet, so I do apologize for that. Oh, is there actually no... Well, they'd all have to go this way anyway. I was thinking, I didn't even realize there's no bridge over here. We have to go kind of around this route no matter what. That's fine. So we might as well just send the team this direction anyway. Rather than walking through the mountains and the forest. Okay, well, kind of stuck. Well, Medion, Kind of want to punch through this quicker. So big damage here. So that guaranteed Medion and Waltz can kill him. Or maybe just Medion. That's fine. Medion doesn't need any more friends. He's fine. He's a prince. Princes don't need friends. Do we rush over? Ah, why not? There's no way they'll be able to kill Waltz, right? They really don't do very much damage, though. Yeah, that's more damage than Tornado would have done. I'm disappointed that they attacked immediately after, but... Like, you can see the power difference here. Eryudo can tank the goblins and deal significant damage to them in return with his onk. When the healer's that tough, you know you're falling behind. Burn with fire. I like those spell descriptions. Alright, well, let's clear the path across the bridge first. I wonder if any of the animations got an update between Scenario 1 and 2, like, if they added some more special effects or anything. You guys let me know if you think you noticed any. It's certainly possible. This actually works out well because, trying to get Hazuki to level 7 anyway here. Quite close enough to the bat. Maybe try to lure it over a little bit. Well, we'll have a slightly longer episode again today because I think we're almost done this battle. Unless something else jumps in from the side, like, it shouldn't take too much longer. So we'll go for the 35-minute episode or whatever again. That should be okay. I'm kind of notoriously bad for sticking to my 30-minute limit. I try to make them all 20 to 30, but... I generally prefer to make sure it ends at a good point. A reasonable ending point rather than a, oh, we hit the timer, time to stop it kind of ending point. Usually my philosophy. I guess you can't quite get there. Hazuki, though. So she does get weapon advantage with a ranged weapon, same as a. Our bow wielders would against flying. Shurikens count as arrows in that sense, which is nice. Knives, though, do not, I believe. Yeah. They still count as swords, even though you're... I mean, like, the difference between a knife and a shuriken... Yeah, a throwing knife and a throwing star, you know. It's fairly minor. But, you know, shurikens can't... be thrown at someone adjacent to you, whereas you can use a knife to stab someone in the eye, I guess. So, they've got that difference. I think Rock could use some healing, right? Yeah, a little bit. Hey, good friends. Yeah, that's the way it always seems to be. Your primary healer, they make friends with everyone eventually, but it does take a little longer than normal. I think, what did I say? It's like 10 or 15 points per friendship level. And killing an enemy gives you like 2 from the last 2 people that attacked it. Damaging an enemy just gives you 1. And I think healing an ally just gives you 1 as well. So, if you're killing a lot of enemies for friendships, you know, that's about twice as fast as healing people. Probably faster than not in the forest. For most people. Yeah, this is a pretty easy map, jeesh. You know, they threw in that chapter one mage, masked mage and priest level that was a real pain. And then now we get this kind of stuff where there's no enemy mages, there's no enemy magic at all. Like, most of the enemies are doing like one damage, so what's the real threat? Would like to leave Hazuki there. What's her defense? Well, I could actually equip that ring for now. I'll have to do some inventory management one of these days and switch some stuff around. Yeah, that'll give her a pretty good amount of defense, sure. Figures. I was just talking about how we're almost done here at 30 minutes. Well, gonna go for the critical attack. Do as much damage as possible here with the Iron Lance. The critical boost from Bernard here to try to protect the healers and all that. Yeah. If I can kill a couple worms before they get a turn, I'll be pretty happy. So, the more damage we can get in here, the better. Maybe I'll get enough for a kill. Ah! Bad rock. Well. Alright. One down. Actually, Rock's attack was completely pointless because Bernard did so much damage. He's a pretty good DPS archer for sure. He does hit hard with that battle bracer. I think we'll try to focus down this one next. Again, we'll go for all-out damage for this turn. To try to kill him in two hits if it's possible. Like, Synthesis should be able to finish that off with magic. She'll go before the worm, right? Yes, certainly. Okay, so she can kill that one. I'll let Waltz take a stab at the further away guy, further away worm. I think if I played my cards correctly, I might be able to kill all three. Probably not much Eryudo can do. He's not going to be able to do 13 damage. I guess we just get an attack in for fun, but won't change anything, I don't think. Sheesh, he does do better damage than I always think. Alright, well, how come the worms are going before Synthesis? Did I... Oh no, Hazuki triggered them and she went after Synthesis. That was my problem, okay. I forgot. They're not really that dangerous anyway. Yeah, Eryudo and Synthesis, that's a good friendship for sure, too. Nice to have that building up. So, I would like Hazuki to kill this one, if we can set it up. So it looks good. So she's paralyzed, though. Shoot. I forget what the odds are, but they're not great. She'll have I think it's maybe 50-50 to not get her attack. She got it anyway. Good, lucky her. Still no level up, but that's okay. We'll use the antidote herb here, I think. I'm pretty sure Eryudo is out of MP now, so he can't use the antidote spell. So we might as well just use the herb. Actually, that's a good point. I should make sure I always bring a couple antidote herbs, the way I've been farming my healers for experience. No, he had enough for one more, technically. Do we just get the choke point here? I think it'd be more beneficial to be here with the terrain bonus. Although we'll do less damage with the initial attack. Maybe we just push in. Yeah, we'll just push forward. Zero can probably open up this choke point. Rock almost got it. We're basically done. All grouping up over here. So, does anyone need some healing so we can get level up? Sure, why not? Don't want to miss out, right? Come on, lots of MP. Two is a good. No defense is sad. I mean, I don't think they can. There's just no way they can break through the rock. And I definitely want to open up this path, so this is the priority. Nice! So Zero starts with level 2 sword, and surprisingly close to level 2 wings as well. So, like, he's got more weapon skill than anyone on the team just because of the way he joins up. That's really nice. Like, there's no point grinding his weapon skills at all anymore because we can't get them any higher until he's promoted. That's kind of crazy. So priority is standing here so that they can't block our movement. I think we'll still go with the ranged attack on the bats first, though. I'd like to see another weapon skill level up here, maybe. I forget, what was the ninja's friendship bonus? Is it something worth... Magic encounter, Not the best support bonus. Reasonable for synthesis, counter I don't really care about. Yudo and Synthesis, if anyone, should be focusing on it, I guess. Should be maybe enough to kill it in one hit? I don't know. The Iron Lance would have done it for sure, but no big deal. Yeah, it's fine. And we'll try to level up that Tomahawk as well. Actually, I think the way weapon skill works, you probably will get... Because you get... I think it's tied to your damage you do. You kind of get more weapon XP by having that friendship support with Medion. Which is kind of neat. Yeah, like if you're getting plus 5 damage from Medion because you're standing beside him, that gives you a little bit more weapon XP on your hits. I hadn't really thought of it before, but that's something to think about. You definitely want to do overkill damage when possible just to level those things up quicker. Fortunately, I was hoping that we'd be able to get an attack across the river here, but... Well, seeing as I just sort of argued Zero out of an attack, he can just wait, let someone else get the kills in. I've been trying to get Hazuki a level up. I don't think she's going to be able to do 12 damage, though. Maybe with a katana, I don't know. Not even close. Yeah, she's definitely a little bit weak, a little bit low on attack power right now. I blame it on the fact that she's still level 0 with her weapons, which is weird, because she joined after 0 and started with way worse weapon skills than he did. So that's a little peculiar, I think. I think I'll let Midian get the level up. Yeah. There you go, Midian. I think he can get 9 XP here, maybe? Not. I'll try. There we go. Good. All the stats. Just what I wanted. Alright, well, I'm actually going to break the episode here because it's already been very long. We'll deal with the aftermath in the next episode. And perhaps, because I'm pretty sure there's a lot of dialogue coming up, we'll rush over to rescue the Symbios Force. So thanks for watching, folks. Hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.